Red Wings fans, stand up. Yeah, we gonna throw them wings up,
wings up, wings up.
Show the league that this is our time. Let's make the city proud. We gon' win the Stanley Cup,
Stanley Cup, Stanley Cup.
After that, we gonna party. We go show everybody. We show them all around the world.
We show them all around the world.
We show them all around the world. We gon' throw them wings up. We gon' throw them wings up.
Maybe you did dream of something like this when you were playing in the North Stars Association.
Yeah, you know, you never really know what to expect growing up. Obviously, this is the goal, and we're here now and just trying to soak it all in.
I know it's obviously news to people of Calgary, but you've been at this for a long time, you know, in junior, in Salmon Arm, and then in Michigan. Is this kind of the culmination of that journey? And what does it mean to you to play in the saddle zone tonight?
Yeah, I mean, I think it'll be really special for me, taking a route that sort of not a lot of guys take, junior to college and college to pro. So I think, pride myself for how I've been able to succeed at each level and continue to try and do the same here.
Who were on your walls growing up?
Definitely like Jerome Iginla, Craig Conroy, those kind of guys looked up to a lot. Iginla was one of those guys who did everything for the team and was all about the team. So I think, I just really admired that about him.
Well, I feel like when we've been really good, we've been a fast team and exciting to watch. I think when we're playing well, we're moving pucks. We're spending a lot of time in the ozone. We're shooting the puck a lot. So you've seen our power play be good. Our penalty kill's been good and our goaltending's been good when we've been a good team, and we need all those things to win. So we got away from that a little bit the past couple games, and I expect we get back to that tonight and play a fast game and play our game tonight.
And the top line with yourself has certainly been scoring a lot as well. Not as much lately, but how good is having a good start knowing what you guys are capable of?
Yeah, it's huge. I think all three of us bring a different dynamic, and we mesh well together. And I think teams are going to adjust and teams are going to key in, but it opens up space for other lines. And you see that with De La Rose's line, and they've been working hard and playing at both ends of the ice. And it's huge for our team. We need all 12 forwards going and all 6D, and we need our goalie to be great. So it's not a one-line team. It's a four-line team that we feel we can roll teams in the ozone and keep the puck there and play there all night.
What does this matchup look like when you look at Calgary? What challenges do you see?
Well, you see their big line as well. You see their power plays, great power play. They got a great defenseman in Mark Giordano. That's hard to play against. And I don't know much about their goalie, but it's a good matchup for us where they play a fast game, a skill game. And if we get on the forecheck and make it hard for their D to break the puck out, like I said before, we want to spend a lot of time in the ozone. And if we make it hard for them to break it out, we're going to spend time there. So we want to make it our forwards against their D and put pressure on them all night.
What do you think with Johnny Gaudreau in the Worlds? What did you find out about him?
I've seen him a lot. He's so dynamic. I think right when you think you got him, you don't. He's so good at cutting back and controlling the puck and finding spaces. He's one guy that, people are always like, why don't you just hit him? And it's not that easy. He just spins off. He makes space for himself and his line mates. And he's got a pretty deceptive shot as well. So, he finds the little pocket that the goalie gives him and usually hits it.
Well, I'd say multiple areas, to be honest with you. I don't know if there's one single area. The one thing that Dylan's done is he's worked really, really hard in the summers after practices and those types of things that improve in his offense. I mean, his skill set has just continued to improve. I think when he was originally drafted, lots of people thought he was a defending type center. I think he's developed into a real two-way threat. I also then would also say he's really bought into trying to become the best winning type centerman he can be, a guy that can check against the other team's best players, but also produce tons of offense. So, he's improved over the years, and he's still got lots of room for improvement. He knows that, and what makes him special is he's willing to work at it.
What do you think about Taro Hirose's journey kind of to the NHL and culminating here tonight? What is this game going to mean to him being from Calgary?
Yeah, you know, I think it says a lot about the fact that guys get to the top of the mountain different ways. And you know, he was obviously an undrafted free agent who went through the Tier 2 route and then made it to Michigan State and had a great career at Michigan State. And we were excited to sign him with the chance that he could be a skill-type player in the National Hockey League. And over the course of his early part of his career, he's done a good job. I think he's still finding ways this year to be more effective offensively, but I think it should be a real good night for him for certain. You know, to be able to come back home and play, I think is awesome. So look forward to him hopefully having a great night. It's not quite the same journey that Doc Ryan took to get to the NHL, as all you know, but it's a good journey.
And his shot, you mentioned his shot has improved. What else has sort of improved in his game this year?
Well, he worked hard this summer at improving his shot. You know, I think he's always going to be a little bit of a slight build. You know, he's tried to put some strength on, but I don't know if that's an area where he's going to make a drastic improvement. I think if his quickness continues to improve, and I guess maybe his elusiveness a little bit. You know, I've had a chance to coach Johnny Gaudreau on a number of world championship teams. What makes Johnny special at a slight build is just his elusiveness, and I think the more Taro can mix that into his game, the better opportunity he's going to be able to keep the puck on his stick more and not have to go physicality for physicality in those matchups.
You mentioned Johnny. What have you seen in the growth of him since he got into the league?
Johnny Gaudreau?
Yeah.
Well, I think he's been pretty good since he got in the league. You know, Johnny was doubted as a younger player because he was small, and he's just proved doubters wrong. I mean, he's an elite offensive player, really an elite winning-type person and player. You know, to watch him, you know, the first year I coached him, the World Championship team, it was great because I had the opportunity to show the rest of the team how hard you're supposed to track and how hard you're supposed to come back and play defense. And, you know, I just think pretty much from day one he's been a real good player in this league.
Jeff, you've done some juggling with Nielsen's line and with Filppula's line and even had them together lately a little bit. What are you trying to find there, or what are you not finding there that's you're trying to find it? You know what I'm saying, trying to find as far as chemistry goes.
Was it a late night last night, Trevor? Holy smokes. Luckily, I've been with you. I can decipher. Yeah. So translating, at the end of the day, we need more offense outside of our top line. And I think that's, you know, now with that, we also need to keep the puck out of our net more, but it's a combination. And so if we need to find other lines that are threats in a two-way sense. And so we'll keep kind of tweaking until we find the right combinations. And usually that happens for a little bit, and then you got to tweak again.
Jeff, have the new challenge rules changed how you approach those situations at all this year? I don't know how many situations you guys have necessarily had, but...
Well, I'd say the challenge rule is 100%. The way, you know, with the goalie interference has 100% changed our approach. You know, before the consequence of being wrong wasn't much of a consequence for goalie interference, and now it's a drastic consequence, and it's a gray rule, so it's hard to, and a gray rule, I mean, it's just gray. That's just the reality of it. Nobody can totally define, and everyone looks a little different, and the interpretation can be a little different. So we got to feel... we're 100% certain when we make that call now. We're last year, you know, we didn't necessarily have to. The one that I've challenged this year, to me, was 100% certain. It was in the blue. He made contact with our goalie's head and totally didn't allow our goalie to play the position. But it can certainly, you know, again, it's up for interpretation. And so anytime that's the case. The other thing that happened to us in preseason was we challenged an offsides that everybody on the planet knew was offsides, but you couldn't actually see the puck in the guy's skate at the same time. You see the flexion of the knee, you see all that, but you couldn't. And so, and that, you know, we got that one wrong and cost us a penalty, but it was great experience because now we know it has to, you have to see both. It's different than the puck in the net in the goalie's glove where you can assume it's there. There's no assumption is what I'm told. So, I guess I'd use common sense, but that's all right. So we got to make sure and see it.